All right, well, we'd like to play first. And this is the first time I've had a glimpse in a decent opening hand, so I guess I'll keep that. Probably leading with Deathrite Shaman here. And maybe turn two, casting a Zenith for two to get an Elvish Visionary, something along those lines. Because all I'm looking for is more one drops and one hit another land drop. So I think trying to search up an Elvish Visionary works out. Basically, with double glimpse in hand, I want to build up mana to take advantage of it and one drop to take advantage of it. So I don't really want to play both my one drops. Clearly, I want to play one on turn one, and Zenith for Visionary finds both those things. There's some argument to trying to assemble the Heritage Druid combo, so using Zenith for Heritage Druid, but I don't think that's actually what I want to do right now. All right, my opponent kept the opener. I'm not worried about playing against a Wasteland here. I mean, I suppose my opponent's deck could have Wasteland. I don't think that's incredibly likely, though. Still actually don't know if my opponent's got Force of Will. I mean, if you're playing all these black and green creatures, it seems a little less likely, but between Brainstorms, maybe like a couple Forces, who knows? Ooh, all right, I like that. Kirin Render is pretty nice. I still am going to go ahead and cast a Zenith here, I guess. I'm just going to get a Forest. Maybe I didn't need to do that, but figured there's no real point in not. I'm basically almost never need double black. Right, Zenith for two. Elvish Visionary, and this also makes any potential Wirewood Symbiote draws better. And it draws me a Gaia's Cradle. Gaia's Cradle is the other card I'm really looking for right now. It's not done anything. Yeah, I like casting Glimpse here. Basically, if it resolves, I can play Kirin Ranger, return a forest to draw a card. And basically, I'm cycling this Glimpse for probably just a couple of cards, not like a million cards. And that's good enough with two. If I only had one, I could see taking another turn to like set up a Green Sun Zenith this turn, maybe get a Mana Elf of some kind. But I think given that I have two, this works out better. Also, my opponent could be considering forcing or something along those lines this glimpse, which I would not mind. Especially since if my opponent forces a glimpse, I just play Kirin Ranger, bounce forest, replay. Well, maybe not. I don't know. Deathrite not tapping for mana here is kind of rough. My opponent may be intentionally not playing fetch lands, which makes sense. So getting a little punished for playing that over Elvish Mystic, but in general, Deathrite's the one you want to have in play first. All right. Apparently, my opponent does have Force of Wills, so Force Pitching Sower, one of the targets we saw last game. Actually, I think I'm just going to play an Elvish Mystic. Elvish Mystic taps for mana, which means that if I have Kirin Ranger, if I play Kirin Ranger, then I can get double mana off that. And I don't really want to play a Ranger as well because of I want to have extra creatures for Glimpse. Pernicious Deed. Oh, Progenitus. How lovely. All right, well, I could just go ahead and get a Reclamation Sage. Do I want to do that? And I guess I have to play a Kirin Ranger anyway. So what if I play Glimpse, play Kirin Ranger, draw a card? Or I can just play Kirin Ranger, two mana. Yeah, I think I just play Kirin Ranger and blow up the deed. I mean, I could play Glimpse first, but if I don't draw, yeah, that's too much. All right, so let's play a Ranger. If my opponent has Force of Will now, then a second Force of Will, then I'm in deep trouble, but I'm gonna assume that's not the case. Since if my opponent has a second Force of Will, I'm in trouble no matter what. What else draw Progenitus? Drawing Progenitus is so bad. It should have protection from being drawn at unnecessary times, which is basically all times. Hopefully this is not the inglorious end of this daily event, but if I lose this game, then that is it. If I don't know, my opponent doesn't have Force Will, I think I'm looking like I'm in decent shape here, but if they do, then who knows? Also, I wish my opponent would just kind of F6 here, if they're just gonna sit here and not do anything for long periods of time, but hey, I guess it's their clock. 1, 2, 3. Alright, there we go. Where is Reclamation Sage? Right there. Boom, I wish to kill Pernicious Deed. And I wish to bash for two. Alright, who needs this glimpse? I'm just beating down manually. can still play Deed and pop it for one, which would still be pretty annoying. Glimpse is actually getting fairly bad now. I have the mana now, but I don't have any elves in my hand. Alright. We are brainstorming. Well, I guess that means I'm not getting deeded for one here. Could still go for Wirewood Symbiote. That would be a nice draw. If I draw any one drop elf, I'm casting Glimpse. If I draw a land, I guess I'm just attacking. Though I'm doing lethal kind of soon. I assume my opponent's deck can stop this motley crew of 1/1s from killing them. And if I draw, I guess if I draw a natural order, I'm just going for a Crater Hoof. If I draw, I don't know, there's not a whole lot else. If I draw Green Sun Zenith, I'm getting a Wirewood Symbiote and start going off with Elvish Visionary here. Veteran Explorer, sure. Does that stop to be done? Glimpse. All right. I think rather than passing the turn, I should just Glimpse and play Nettle Sentinel and hope against hope. Well, I could actually double Glimpse. And then if my top card is a creature, that's really good for me. All right. If my top two cards are creatures, that's really good. All right. Come on, Glimpse. All right. We are kind of getting there. I don't want to play a land yet because of Gaia's Cradle. So let's just untap, tap, play another Nettle Sentinel. Oh, there's a Cradle. Cradle's good. All right. Let's play the Cradle. I think I just tap it for millions, play Nettle. Elves is going off. That hasn't happened yet. I guess we're... this is what this deck's trying to do. Wirewood Symbiotes, there we go. Alright. And now I just need to find a Heritage Druid, and then that'll do it. Alright. Yeah, I need to auto-yield all these Nettle Sentinels. Alright. And Elvish Visionary. Oh, they're not the same trigger, so I can't F7 them all into the stack. Alright. Bam. Well, there's lots of Gaia's Cradles, but it's going to be hard for me to not go off here. I mean, I guess technically I could not draw or find Heritage Druid here, but that seems kind of unlikely, given that I've got a lot of mana and there's the Green Sun Zenith, also a natural order. Alright, let's just cast Zenith for one, so I can get Heritage Druid, and then even if this natural order gets countered, not that my opponent has any counters, I think we're well past that point. Alright. 1, 2, 3, and sure, let's tap these three as well. The fact that Reclamation Sage is an elf is just absurd. It's very funny. Let's sack Visionary. It's not going to be necessary to do anything else here. And where is the Crater Father? Bam. And yeah, that should be enough. Attacking for millions. And what am I hitting my opponent for? I don't get to see. 13, 39, plus 17. Alright, that's a pretty nice little amount. 56 damage there or whatever. From what I saw, Force of Will, Pernicious Deed. Still really want Abrupt Decay. I could actually see Thoughtseize being decent. Scavenging was actually sounding less good to me. Maybe putting just like two Thoughtseizes here. And again, taking out some of the one drops. Alright. Pretty light touch, but I think that's all I want here.